Hi, and welcome to this Tech Talk. I'm Peter Dubois, and I'm a technical designer at Cegeka. In previous videos, we've been talking about how to integrate between Microsoft Dynamics 365 Finance and Operations and Microsoft Dynamics 365 Customer Engagement. We've talked about dual write, the CDS Data Integrator, and virtual entities. But what if none of those meet your integration requirements? Well, in this last video, we will zoom in on the FinOps and Dataverse connectors. Now, let's take a look at what the connector is. The connector is a wrapper, a proxy, which lies around the Finance and Operations or Dataverse API, making it easier for you to communicate with the underlying OData services. This wrapper handles a lot of things for you, from authentication and authorization to creating the message payload, sending a message, and handling the response. The connectors provide a pre-built set of triggers and actions, which can be used to build your integration in a low-code way. Now, the connector is only a building block. It's not a complete integration platform. And those building blocks can be used either in Power Apps or in Power Automate or in Logic Apps, which is a part of Azure Integration Services, on which Cegeka has built a complete integration platform. So how do you configure the connector? First up, the system requirements. The connectors are available for all online deployments. They can be used for on-premises deployments as well, but then you need a site-to-site VPN, which can be quite expensive. And as I said before, the connector is only a building block, so you will need a Power Apps or Power Automate or Logic Apps to actually set up your integration using those connectors. Now let's talk about setting up the connector. Setting up the connector is actually a quite straightforward process. The first time you want to use the building block, you need to set up authentication for your connector, for your building block. You can authenticate either using an actual user as it is known in FinOps or Customer Engagement, or you can connect using an Azure AD service principle. Once you set up authentication and authorization, you can reuse that connection for all other building blocks. So this step you actually only have to perform once. Now that we have completed the initial setup, let's take a look at the actual configuration. All configuration depends on which tooling you want to use to configure the building blocks. So either Power Automate or Power Apps or Logic Apps. But in any case, the configuration is always done in a very handy visual designer. The connector provides two types of components: triggers and actions. First, let's discuss the triggers. A trigger can be seen as something that happens in your application or in your system. For example, when a customer is created or when a contact is updated, you need your integration flow to run. The Finance and Operations connector provides you with one trigger when a business event occurs. When you select this trigger, you simply have to configure four parameters. Which environment do you want to use? Which category of business event, what business event, and for which legal entity. The Dataverse connector provides triggers for the basic CRUD operations, so when a record is created, updated, or deleted. And when you use the connector within Power Automate, you get an additional trigger for when a record is selected and the flow needs to run on that record. On the other hand, you have actions. An action is an event or a request that you want to execute in an application or in a system. For example, you want to create a customer, you want to update a contact, or you want to retrieve one or multiple records. The FNO connector provides actions for the normal CRUD operations, so creating, updating, or deleting a record, for retrieving one or multiple records, or for executing finance and operations procedures. The Dataverse connector also provides actions for the basic CRUD operations, for retrieving one or multiple records. And if you use the Dataverse connector within Power Automate, you even get some more actions, like relating records, uploading images, executing business logic in Dataverse, and so on. Now, the actual configuration depends on what action or what trigger you want to use, but the visual editor always guides you through that configuration. For example, it will provide field descriptions or provide drop-downs where possible, or give you an indication of what fields are required. Now, what about application lifecycle management? Source control and deployment is very much depending on what integration tooling you are using. When you are using Power Automate or Power Apps, source control is very limited and there's actually no reliable solution in place for that. Although I have to say that Microsoft is working very hard to improve this. Deployment of Power Apps and Power Automates actually works in the very same way as you would deploy any component in your customer engagement environment. You can simply add a Power Automate or a Power Apps to your solution, export that solution, and import the solution in a target environment. When using Logic Apps, you can show and edit the code behind your Logic App in Visual Studio. And that code you can store in your favorite source control management system. Parameterized deploys are possible, either from Visual Studio doing it manually, or automated in, for example, Azure DevOps. So based on our experiences, what are the advantages of using the connectors? First of all, using the connector eliminates the need to write custom code to perform a call to either finance and operations or customer engagement, because the connector handles a lot of things for you. It handles authentication, creating the message payload, sending the message, and handling the response, thus eliminating a lot of development costs. Since the connector is only a building block, you can actually tailor your complete integration completely to your wishes. You can combine it with other components in the Azure Integration Services, for example, the Azure Service Bus, thus creating a very performant but loosely coupled integration. As I explained, all configuration is done in a very handy visual editor, which guides you through the process. On top of that, you can use Visual Studio to edit your Logic App, and that enables you to switch between the visual editor and the code behind. This code behind you can then use for more complex scenarios or for parameterization. The connectors provide some very useful additional settings. First, you can secure your inputs and outputs so that when you go through the execution logs, some values are not displayed. This comes in handy in situations where you don't want just everyone to see which data is coming in or going out. Second, you can mark the connector as asynchronous. This means that the connector will keep polling the target environment to see if an action has completed. Additionally, you can set a timeout value to define how long the system has to keep polling before returning an invalid response. Thirdly, you can set up a retry policy. Well, actually, this is enabled by default and you can configure it the way you want. This retry policy will make the system retry a call several times when it gets a failure response from the application server. And finally, looped actions, for example, creating a lot of order lines, can be executed in parallel, which obviously has a good impact on the integration running time. Do be aware though of the API limits, but I'll get to that a little bit later in this video. Another advantage is that the finance and operations connector can be used for any data entity or procedure that exists in finance and operations, provided that it is marked as public. This goes for out-of-the-box entities and procedures, as well as custom ones. And the same goes for the Dataverse connector. You can address any entity or business logic that is available in your environment, both out-of-the-box or custom ones. Because of the available triggers and actions and the many available data entities and business logic, it's possible to meet a lot of your integration requirements simply by combining those available out-of-the-box components. And even if the required functionality is not possible using the out-of-the-box components, you can always extend your data entities or procedures at finance and operations side, or your entities or custom entities and business logic at Dataverse side. Although most of that is seen as custom development, they are considered as pretty standard practices in both applications. And when it comes to error handling and monitoring, regardless of what integration platform you are using, you are able to see the execution history of your integration runs. When something went wrong, you are perfectly capable to see what went wrong exactly. And when you're using Power Automate or Logic Apps, you can resubmit a failed run with one simple click of a button. By the way, this is one of the strengths of our Cegeka integration platform, which provides you with a consolidated overview of the status of your integrations. And the final advantage that I want to add here concerns the cost. When you have a Dynamics license, there's actually no extra cost to use the building blocks in your Power Automate or in your Power Apps. When working with the connectors, there's also a few things to be aware of or to be on the lookout for. First of all, the number of triggers for the Finance and Operations connector is very limited. Where most other connectors provide triggers for when a record is created or updated or deleted, the Finance and Operations connector only provides one trigger. Although FNO does provide a list of business events, it's very likely that you will have to configure alerts or extra business events to meet your requirement, which has a negative impact on performance. As I explained, the connectors use the underlying OData APIs. As you might know, OData APIs are not suitable for big volumes of data. And as such, Microsoft has applied throttling limits to the connectors. This means that in a time window or time frame of 60 seconds, you can perform only 1,000 calls to Dataverse or 200 calls to Finance and Operations. Luckily, Microsoft is still in the process of fine-tuning this. Now, since the application connectors actually provide an HTTP call to the APIs, you could choose to replace it with the standard HTTP connector. From our experience, we have noticed that the performance of the HTTP connector is actually slightly better than the specific application connectors, and you can achieve functionality using the HTTP connector that the specific connector could not achieve. I have to add though that the HTTP connector increases complexity. So when you design your integrations, you have to weigh the increased complexity against the performance. Using the connector in a logic app is like any other building block within logic app, not for free. Every action execution will cost you 0.000106 euros, which is still not expensive to me. It means that when you have 10,000 runs a day with one action execution, for that day you would still pay more or less 1 euro. You do have to beware of multiplexing scenarios. I won't go in too much detail here in this video about that because there's a lot of Microsoft documentation concerning the topic. Although configuring the connector is not a technical task as such, you probably will end up needing a technical resource, either for extending data entities or procedures at Finance and Operations side, or developing extra additional custom logic on Dataverse side. Also, if you want to use advanced source control or parameterized deployments using Visual Studio, you will end up needing a technical resource. And a final point to add, the Dataverse connector actually provides more actions if you use it within Power Automate, like uploading images or calling actions in Dataverse. It's really too bad that those actions are not available when you use the building block within a logic app. So, what's our conclusion? We're a very big fan of the application connectors, especially combining them with other components in Azure Integration Services. When you use the connectors together with other available components, it's very easy to set up a performant and reliable integration setup that will tailor you to all your needs, even the most complex ones. However, do take into account that this is not a complete integration platform. It's only a box of building blocks that you can use to design your integration. So you will absolutely need someone to guide you in designing and thinking about your integrations. And you will also need resources to implement it. Of course, here at Cegeka, we can advise and assist you in designing and developing your integration scenarios. Or if appropriate, we can leverage the power of the Cegeka integration platform, which we have developed as a complete integration platform. So that's it. Thanks a lot for watching. Please subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to stay informed of future updates. Have a very nice day.